What is up, YouTube? Tyler Secrist here. This week's episode is going to be a monthly market update for March in both Fort Wayne, Indiana, and the Grand Strand in South Carolina.
Welcome to the Weekly Tea. Look, I'm not going to be everybody's cup of tea, and I'm cool with that.
Thanks for tuning in, guys. Again, Tyler Secrist here. For those new to the channel who don't know who I am, I'm a real estate agent and a real estate investor in Fort Wayne, Indiana, and Pawleys Island, South Carolina. My agency, my license is held with Century 21 Bradley, the number one Century 21 in the world, both in here in Indiana and down there in South Carolina. I own a private real estate firm called Secrist Marketing Group, where we buy, sell, build, create. Our latest project is a spec in Eagle Rock. We'll kind of flash some B-roll of that. You should actually go to the drone and get that, because that's all on the outside and inside. Let me know when you get the quote. Text me when you get there. I'll give you the code so you can go inside. Drywall's hung.
Nice.
Drywall's hung. The entire exterior is done except the stone. It looks fucking good.
Today ain't even my birthday, but I can ball if I want to. Pull up on cars if I want to. How about that through that on in my jumpsuit?
Go.
Just do what I say and I love you, okay? I get this from my uncle. I told Bay get 22 inches of...
That's set to be on the market at the end of next month. So stay tuned for that. Really excited for that. Let's hop in today's video. Okay, so today we're talking about the current status of the market at the end of March 2022 in both here in Fort Wayne, Indiana, and the Grand Strand down in South Carolina. We're going to talk about Indiana first, and then we'll talk about South Carolina later. So let's just hop into it. So right now we'll go over the current market update right here for March of 2022. We're just going to go over the four key components that I do every month. And then on this side, we will add last year's data, and we'll kind of compare to where we were at last year compared to where we're at this year, and kind of where I think things are kind of headed. And then we'll switch gears and we'll talk about South Carolina. But right now, as you can see, the average sale price at the end of March of 2022 was $241,186. That's not much of a change from last month, 0.5%. Very, very small change.
I am small.
The inventory of homes for sale, 156 properties. Again, we're down 3.1% from last month. Not the direction we need to be going, in my opinion, but still very low inventory. The average day on market, 21 days. That means it's taking about 3 weeks for a property to get put under contract. That is super interesting to me, because I would say here in Indiana and Fort Wayne specifically, I've noticed, I'm really intrigued to see where April lies, because I noticed a 3 week period where things kind of slowed down a bit. I think it was a combination of the latest rate hike and honestly, spring break.
Spring break.
Here locally, we had our spring break where all the schools in Fort Wayne and the surrounding areas, it was about a 3 week period. They're all different. It wasn't just one unanimous, you know, week. This school district had their spring break this week, the next, so on and so forth. But I listed a ton of property through that period of time, and I noticed it was taking a lot longer for that stuff to get put under contract, and some of it still isn't under contract yet. I'm just curious to see the numbers in April to see if that was the reasoning behind it, just to see if that was just specific or contextual to my business. I'm really intrigued by that, because the fact that this moved 25% faster than last month when I saw things slow down a bit, I'm really, really, really interested to see what that figure is in April. But today, I should say at the end of March, current interest rates were 4.25% to 5%. Today's date is April 12th. And I actually wanna bring this in this video, because rates are now at 5.25%. They went up this morning. So those are today's current numbers, roughly. Here, we've got 2022s up here. We're gonna throw up March 2021 here so we can compare. At the end of March in 2021, the average sale price was just over $205,000. So compared to last year and this year, we're up, you know, 35 some thousand dollars from last year, just after a year difference. The inventory of homes for sale, 147 last year, 156 this year, not much of a change. I wish we would get more inventory in the marketplace. I think that would help a lot of these skyrocket sale prices kind of cool off a little bit, but no real change in there. I constantly get asked, hey, when do you think things are gonna calm down? Do you think things are gonna continue to go blah, 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 blah? When you're looking at these numbers like I am on a weekly, sometimes daily basis, and then I make these videos for you guys on a monthly basis, it's part of me educating you so that you can see for yourself. I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. You know, what's going on. You're reading a ton of different headlines. You may be listening to a ton of people in my field or maybe even like me. Maybe they're telling you contradicting things. These are the numbers, you know? You know, when I say something, what I say is backed by real hard data and the truth. So that's what you'll find here, is I'm always gonna be authentic. I'm always gonna, you know, tell you the truth and just serve it to you on a silver platter. And then what you take from that, you know, is on you at the end of the day. But yeah, I mean, just look at last year compared to this year. Everything is pretty much consistent except the sale price is higher and the rates are higher. So me saying the longer you wait, the more expensive it's gonna get. I mean, I'm like a broken record. So yeah, 147 inventory last year, 156 this year. I mean, pretty much the same. Average day on market, 26 days last year, 21 days this year. Again, not a big change. It's like about 3 weeks it's taking something to, you know, get put under contract, which is very, very, very fast. Last year rates were around 3 to 3.5 to where they're now at 5.25, you know? So that's kind of tough to stomach, because I had a lot of clients last year at this time who were kicking around the idea of, you know, doing something and didn't for whatever reason. I know they're regretting it now, and it's really unfortunate, because you know, everything that's kind of transpired through this year, I was educating them on last year. So those are the figures for this year. That is the analysis from last year to this year. Super interesting stuff. What do I think is going to happen moving forward? I mean, it's more of the same, guys. I think rates are going to, you know, I think they may creep up even further. I think the average day on market will kind of stay consistent. I think it'll take anywhere from, you know, 2 weeks to a month to move some product. I think the inventory will stay about the same. I do know people like to move in the summer a lot.
Sorry, I'm making a go of it in a new city.
Now that school is, you know, graduation is close and school is gonna be out for children, I think a lot of families will move, and employers like to relocate employers at this time. So I'm hoping we see a little spike of inventory through this summer of 2022. But I still think the average sale price is going to continue to go up, you know, marginally through the end of this year. So that's my 2 cents on that. Now, fresh to the channel, finally a member of the Coastal Carolina Association down in South Carolina, so I can pull data and educate you guys on the marketplace down there. I'm excited because the little and the few people who do watch my videos, me being licensed in another state on the other side of the country is going to help give you guys perspective. If you don't travel much, if you've never been outside of Fort Wayne, it's really tough to understand or the value of the economy of where you live. This Fort Wayne has been one of America's most affordable cities for a very extended period of time. I constantly hear negativity and people complain about pricing and how tough they think they have it here when they have no fucking idea how great we have it here on a national scale. So I'm hoping seeing some of these numbers will help bring some perspective or maybe shine some light on that. So the next time you think, you know, something at 250 is, you know, really, really expensive. Yeah, it may be expensive compared to, you know, what it's been recently, but to give you perspective on what it's like in other places, I mean, not just the world, but, you know, in the country, I hope that'll, you know, kind of shine some light on that. But for at the end of March of 2022, the Grand Strand, since I serviced that whole area, I didn't want to, and I live in Pawleys, which is on the southern portion of the Grand Strand. Kind of, it's really far away from Myrtle Beach and North Myrtle. It's just a totally different ecosystem. I wanted to kind of make this more broad scale and do the Grand Strand entirely. So if you guys don't know what the Grand Strand is, it's a part of South Carolina on the northern coast from North Myrtle Beach all the way down to Georgetown. There's five or six different cities. You've got North Myrtle Beach, you've got Myrtle Beach, you've got Surfside, you've got Garden City Beach, you've got Merle's Inlet, and then you've got Pawleys Island where I live, and then you've got, you know, Georgetown. You got Conway and Secrist, or however you pronounce it. We'll fact check that. Obviously not down there enough to know how to pronounce that, but you've got some intercoastal cities that are kind of within that. But that is the geographic area that I'm pulling these data, these numbers from for this data. But on average for the Grand Strand, the average sale price right now is just north of $400,000. So that's a pretty big figure if you live in Fort Wayne, Indiana, and you're used to the average sale price being, you know, 240. But the Grand Strand, the average sale price is just over 400 grand. The inventory of homes for sale, there's about 1,600 homes. That may seem like a lot, but it's really not when you break that down into six different, you know, cities. To give you guys context here in Fort Wayne, that would be like me pulling numbers for Fort Wayne, Huntertown, Leo, Ossian, Monroeville, Hoagland, Auburn, Garrett. It would be like me combining all of that, you know, within one. It's the total single family homes, condos for sale right now in the Grand Strand. And then the average day on market right now in that area is about 125 days, which is totally different than, you know, the ecosystem that we see here in Fort Wayne. Current interest rates, about 5.25% on a 30-year fixed rate. They were around 5% at the end of March, but like I said, it's April 12th when we're making this piece, and I want to give you guys real data. And they literally just increased this morning to where it's about 5.25%. So those are the numbers for the Grand Strand in South Carolina. Obviously, I haven't been licensed down there, you know, long enough to really have an opinion. I'm still learning, mastering my craft in that ecosystem. I have been traveling down there my entire life since I was a little kid. I've had my place down there since I started building that in March of 2021. I just got it furnished and moved into it and was complete earlier this year of 2022. But I've been paying attention to the market, I would say, for about 2 or 3 years now in this fashion. What I'm seeing down there is there's just more inventory down there. And it's a different type of living down there. You do have a ton of locals, a lot of retirees. You do have young professionals in the bigger cities like Myrtle Beach direct, but it's a very, very, very popular second home destination. There's a lot of, if I had to break down, I should look into the geographics on that or the demographics on that, what the percentage of second home owners are down there compared to retirees, compared to, you know, people just actively, you know, working there, or what I would consider locals. It's pretty like even hefty mix, like a third, a third, a third, if I had to like guess. But I may look into that and share that with you guys. But like I said, it's just different down there. You're close to the beach. There's a lot of amazing golf courses there, just a different type of lifestyle. So, and I got licensed down there for different reasons. So yeah, if you guys have made it this far, thank you for watching the video. I hope this brings some sort of value for those who do watch it. If you haven't already, please hit the like button, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel, anything to help the algorithm pick it up and put this video in front of more people who else might find it useful. And if there's any topic ideas that you guys want me to elaborate further on, please tell me in the comment section down below. Tell me what you want to know, anything you want me to educate you on, anything you want me to show. Yeah, just drop something down there. See you guys next week.